Hello, exalted viewers of the popular internet television program Arena Boys. Chief Arena Boy, Arena Boy Prime, Riley Knight here. No intro this week, and I'll tell you why. We're playing Arclight Adventures. We're playing that dumb deck that is capable of getting Arclight Phoenix out on turn one. How, you ask? Well, with a combination of Once Upon a Time, Rosethorn Acolyte, Merchant of the Vale, and Arclight Phoenix, in addition to an untapped green source, it's possible to play Arclight Phoenix on turn one. Do we achieve this goal? Are we slapping our opponents upside the head for 3 damage on turn number one? You'll have to watch the video to find out. We're not giving it away by showing you in the intro, my friends. Frank Karsten calculated that it happens 1 in every 20 times. You've got about a 5% chance of it happening. So, stick around, tune in, and see if we roll that natural 20. Now, please enjoy our humorous introduction, accompanied, of course, with the music of Joachim Karud. Take it away, Joachim. Focus up, nerds. It's time to enter the arena. With me, Riley Knight, and joining me this week and every week, Torelf Toffel Severin, the Mythic Champion. I wasn't finished. The Mythic Champion. There we go. And Jamin Kalf.
Focus up, nerds. It's time to enter the arena. With me, Jamin Kalf, and alongside me, we have Riley Knight.
You're gonna start... Okay, so you can't
and
think...
And the Mythic Champion, Torelf Toffel Severin.
All right,
this week we have green-red Arclight Adventure. Let's take a look at the decklist right here. We're topping off our curve here with 3 drops. Obviously, the main goal of this whole deck is to reanimate Arclight Phoenix. What can you tell us about that, Riley?
That was quite a power move, my friend. Wow. That was quite a... I just feel like I've just been just dumped on the side of the roadside completely unceremoniously. But the thing is, Jamie, this is why we have me do it and not you, because that was full of mistakes. First of all, the curve doesn't stop top at 3, because all of these, mate, all of these are 1 and 2 drops.
No, shut up.
Oh, wow. What a well thought out and reasoned response there. Anyway, I'm gonna grab the reins back off of my errant co-host here. So, people have probably seen this deck. It's also Arclight Adventures. There's an S at the end there that's kind of hidden away. So, see, it looks easy. My job looks easy, but there's a lot of stuff hidden away underneath the surface here.
No, honestly, like... Toffel and I have done some commentating now, and it's incredibly hard. Like, I respect your work so much, Riley.
No, go on. If you finished complimenting me, or because I'm happy to listen to you keep on saying stuff, so it's nice. I just wanted to chat. I didn't want to be rude and talk over you. Anyway, so people might have seen this deck before. It made a bit of a splash in week one of the format, and then people forgot about it, including us, because we were like, we're definitely going to play this deck, and then we forgot, and now we're going to bring it back. And hopefully enough, people haven't seen the deck already to think that we came up with it. I kind of ruined that by saying that we've seen it before, and also I'm going to ruin it further by saying it was actually sent in by alert viewer.
You see how skilled
Harrison
Riley is?
JR, so I kind of stuffed that one up from the beginning. But look, I'm very excited to play this list. Turn one, Arclight Phoenix is possible with Once Upon a Time, Rosethorn Acolyte, and I don't know, Merchant of the Vale. We can dump an Arclight Phoenix in the bin, bring it back straight away. Outside of that, I mean, plenty of ways to get a Phoenix in the bin with Thrill of Possibility and the Merchant as well. But also, we can just play the Edgewall Innkeeper value game, because we're playing actual, like, very good adventure cards anyway. So, I don't know. I haven't played with this deck enough to know how the games are going to pan out, how many times we're going to get a turn one Arclight Phoenix. I guess the viewers already know if we've done that or not because they've watched the highlight intro. But I think we're going to have, regardless, any deck within Edgewall Innkeeper and Lucky Clover, I'm going to have a lot of fun. I know that.
All right, then let's have a lot of fun. But first,
it's time for everyone's favorite part of the Arena Boys videos. It's time for, roll the music, the ad for ChannelFireball.com. My friends, let me tell you a story. Once upon a time, there was a magic retailer that you will be shocked to find out offered a wide range of Magic singles and accessories at very... There's nothing about competitive prices in here, aren't they?
Bone-crushing prices.
Bone-crushing prices. The merchants at Channel Fireball are stocked with the latest deals. You'll be love-struck when you see the competitive prices and... Just think of
the thrill of buying cards off their website. The possibilities that open up when you buy your Arclight Phoenixes.
Buy your Arclight Phoenixes at ChannelFireball.com. Rose Thorn Acolyte.
That could have been much bigger. It's like, there's ChannelFireball. You can buy Shock, Edra Innkeeper, Lucky.
We could have done a lot better there as well. We do talk a lot about the fact that they buy and sell cards. It's a buy list, of course. 40% store credit bonus on all trade-ins, da-da-da-da. Also, bunch of free strategy content on
right now, you're watching strategy cards.
You're watching the best. You're watching the very best. But I do suggest you go and check out other stuff. Of course, I make a bunch of stuff there. The MTG Countdown has just kicked off in the last couple of weeks. There's also Scrimey a River, the advice podcast I was with Dennis.
Scrimey a River!
But if you want to watch, more serious Magic, unfortunately... You can't. This is about as serious as it gets. But if you want to watch some people muck around with silly decks, there's like Luis playing, you know, Delver Grixis Legacy or whatever, and like Gucci playing some Pioneer something.
You know, the Mythic Champion, Andrea Mengucci.
Is he a Mythic Champion?
No.
Oh no, the Invitational. I'm sorry.
He's not in that exalted rank.
I mean, actually, to be fair, at this point in time, this could actually be true.
Oh, we need to deal with this. Tuffle, congratulations on winning another Mythic Championship after we'd recorded this video already.
I mean, losing the finals of a Mythic Champion sucks, but losing to Tuffle was fine for me.
Mm. Hang on 1 second, and then we'll do the other one. Jamin, congratulations on winning a Mythic Championship. I never thought you could do it. Wow, and, we never saw it coming.
It's funny how the... Actually, the words were fake. The intention was not.
And now we'll do the third one. Oh, boys. Such a shame that you both missed out on winning the Mythic Championship. Oh, so close, both of you as well.
So close.
All right, I'll just edit out whichever one is not relevant there because we are recording this ahead of time. The Mythic Championship hasn't finished, but hasn't even started, actually. So, well done, boys. Regardless of your result, I'm still... I guess still proud of you, whatever.
Proud?
Yeah.
Just say proud one time.
Just
right.
One time, yeah.
One time!
you're using your one time on probably the most useless... anyway.
You know, suspicious viewers might have noticed that the Hydra deck was still selected.
And I'm telling you
that Riley has not been grinding the ladders.
No, I've been playing it nonstop. I haven't played a game with any other deck since we recorded our last video, and you will notice... That we're still in gold, so
And conveniently still at the same rank.
Are you kidding?
This is okay. Almost the intro.
It's
all right.
No. We just need a discard outlet.
Yeah, we just need one.
We find it with Once Upon a Time.
Okay, all right. So if we find Merchant of the Veil with Once Upon a Time, it's a turn one Arclight Phoenix.
It's a wrap.
We don't have to do anything else. All right, here we go.
Oh God.
Here we
Come
go.
On, one time.
One time. Oh, boo. You want to land or you want an old bone crusher?
Probably land.
Yeah.
Yeah, right. Okay. And let's go mountain. Oh, it does it automatically. That's right. It's very smart. Arena's very smart. So I played the mountain we didn't reveal, but then it just changes that. So, yeah.
And
very clever.
Since we got into gold, both games we played were against turn one Goose.
Yep. Yep.
Wait, no.
One please, Bone Crusher Giant there.
You should have used a giant.
Oh. Oops.
Now it's Innkeeper time.
Innkeeper, yep. Yeah, see, I knew we were going to cast an Edgewall Innkeeper next turn, so I wanted to make sure that was going to be a turn 2 play there. Yeah,
very big brain there.
Huge brain. All right. Just
we kill this, right?
Just Bone Crusher
Giant,
right?
We definitely do.
Yeah, just kill that. All right. Get out of here, Incubation Druid. The Oko decks don't usually play Incubation Druid.
No, they don't.
Get in there.
I mean, turn 2 Incubation Druid, turn 3 Oko is much less impressive than...
Yes,
turn 2 Oko.
Okay, there's the Oko.
The problem is that Oko is still impressive.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we can pressure Oko pretty effectively with an Arclight Phoenix.
then it becomes a 3-3.
Okay. All right.
That's also the problem. Like, no matter how good your creature is, it's just a 3-3.
Okay, so we do Once Upon a Time. I mean, if we're confident in finding the discard thingy, we can... I mean, we have to Rosenthorn, don't we? Because if we don't find an Akko right now, like, if we don't find...
Okay, let's just find Merchant of the Vale.
But this doesn't work.
Yeah, this doesn't work. Whatever.
Okay.
Let's get another Innkeeper.
Do we want another land?
What for?
Yeah, I mean, oh God.
Okay.
Problem is that that's a problem. You never get back. Like, Akko is just.
Yeah.
Yep. So good. Man. Well, look, losing the first game. I don't want to say we're putting this one out to pasture just yet, but losing the first game is a time-honored Arena Boys tradition. So if it happens, it happens. All right, there's question
B. And once again, our opponent has done, like, taken so many game actions. Like,
so just for those of you just joining us with this week, welcome. By all means, welcome. But this is the first game we played after finishing recording. We did two in a row. The recording. So the last one where we got dunked on by Akko in the last week's video, now this is what we're following it up with. So yeah, it's an unhappy time here in Arena Boys HQ. All right, what are we up to?
So hit me up, right? We discard the Phoenix to the merchant and draw another merchant.
Yeah, because otherwise we don't reanimate the Phoenixes.
Well, we can draw Thrill and then somehow get there.
All right. So
Merchant.
But Thrill, actually.
Merchant. Discard
actually, any
the Phoenix.
Spell's good,
but... Okay. How about a land?
Yeah, whatever, we're toast.
Yeah, we're just dead, aren't we? Yeah, let's end the misery right now, man.
I mean, our opponent once again played many impactful spells.
Akko. Yeah.
Do you get like Questing a Akko deck when you get gold?
Maybe that's what it is. I didn't receive the notification, but you know, it is staggering because so we hit silver last video, and then as soon as we hit gold last video, and as soon as we hit gold, we just played against that Akko deck. And now, in our second game in gold, let's see if it happens again. Let's see if it's just mono Akko from here on out. Oh, this is a bit of a stinker. What do you think of this hand?
Yeah.
I think it's fine.
Keep it? All right.
Should be playable, but not great.
I mean, we got the shock for the goose. If they go forest goose, man. All right. That's... It's at least a little bit different.
Do we shock that?
Definitely.
Okay.
Forest? We have to take the forest, right? Otherwise, we don't have any green sources.
But, like, Innkeeper is so juicy. I think we can
draw. Yeah, I like Innkeeper. Right, just Innkeeper. Draw a forest some other time.
And I'm going to shock the sucker here. Oh, and we can go Lucky Clover into Bonecrusher Giant. The value. So good.
So good.
All right, what's next here? Oh.
Whoa.
Our opponent is on our tech. All right. It's not really our tech. People have been playing Lucky Clover for a long time. So, I don't know what... Hopefully they play two Edgewall Innkeepers here. Okay, that's one.
Okay, that's number one.
All right.
Aww.
I'll do. Just kill it, right?
Yeah, we just bone crush it.
I think we also loot.
Yeah, I like that too.
So let's loot first.
Loot first.
So do we ditch the mountain?
I think we don't need the third one. Just draw another.
Yeah, just ditch the mountain.
If we don't draw another land, we can't cast the stomp.
We have two discards. That's fine.
Okay.
I
don't agree with that at all. Okay, I'm not. Oh, okay. Let's not discard this one. Yeah.
Okay. Let's discard the edge wall.
Oh.
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah. We were sailing pretty close to the wind there. All right. So Bone Crusher.
I didn't know how Merchant of the Vale works. I thought you discard once.
Oh no! You discard twice.
Well, you discard once and then.
And then discard again. It's not as an additional cost to cast this spell. It's just you may discard if you do. Oh, I'm so jealous.
That's a very strong curve.
Oh, that's really, really, really cool. Man.
Is fine, right? Now we draw a card.
Yeah, we draw a card. We draw one card off of our Bone Crusher Giant. All right. Opponent having to think about which land they want to get here. A swamp is a wise choice. Okay. There's Order of Midnight getting back that. All right. That's
fine. Oh, getting back everything.
But, yeah. But that's fine. If they play both, then we just bone crush them, mate. Oh, yeah. And again. All right. So, H-Wall Innkeeper.
Innkeeper and Merchant, probably? Or do you want...
No, just... A, yeah, Giant.
Just Bony okay. G, mate. Bony G, draw a card.
Bony G.
Bony G.
Okay.
Okay, good. We're in good shape. It's a shame we had to discard our other Edgewalling... Oh, please play the other Edgewalling Keeper. No. Cindervines? What is this card?
Cindervines.
Whenever an opponent casts a non-creature spell, Cindervines deals 1 damage to the player. Sacrifice it, destroy target artifact or enchantment. It deals 2 damage to that person that permits control. Okay. All right. I accept your terms. So we have to take one now... Oh, they're going to send a Vines out. Yeah, that's fair enough. All right.
Well, that's fine. So now we kill Innkeeper and play Giant.
Another right? Giant, yeah.
Yeah, seems fine. All right, so we go Stomp. Stomp this. Play another Giant. I'm going to do something that I think you guys are probably going to disagree with. Let's draw a card. No. Attack with all. Oh, I was hoping there'd be at least a little bit of a pause so you could go, wait, no. What are you doing?
No, uh-uh. We had that last week.
I know, but I was going to... It's been a week since then, Jamin. Maybe you've forgotten.
Oh, right, man. In that week, I forgot so many interactions.
Yeah, exactly.
It was such a long time.
Order of Midnight can't block.
So what do we do against this giant?
The Beanstalk giant.
I guess it doesn't come down.
They could have cast it just now, but decided not to. All right. I mean, it's tough, right? That's a big... It's a big bouncing boy. I guess we just don't attack and we wait for an Arclight Phoenix.
Yeah. Although, does it have reach?
No.
How does that thing not have reach?
Yeah, no. You think you just shoot a big, like a Spider-Man sort of beanstalk up into the sky there.
Ah, they're out of red. Okay. Okay, this looks good.
Okay, so...
Do we get rid of the second Innkeeper?
You want to kill this? I think so. I'm happy to do that.
How much damage do we do? 9? Almost enough. Yeah, sure.
All right.
Yeah.
We probably would jump anyways. So.
Stomp this. And then just play another Bone Crusher Giant?
Sure.
Seems fine, right?
I mean, there's no Maelstrom Pulled.
No.
There is...
Oh, Deputy of Detention. If they go white and then blue, oh, we're toast.
This Legion thing doesn't hit it. Also, no. They take damage if they target a giant. So
that's true, yeah.
Ooh, they have a Murderous Rider? That hurts on the giant, huh?
Yeah, so these, like, killing these is going to cost them 2 life. Yep.
Yeah, but like twice.
Oh, no. Oh, and they take 4 from the... From the double Murderous Rider, from the double Swift End as well. Yeah.
Oh, they're taking a lot of damage there.
Okay. I'll leave that in hand. Yeah. Although we can just discard the Rosethorn Acolyte, to be honest. Okay. All right. So now they can play Beanstalk Giant. Beanie G, as opposed to Bony G.
Beanie G. I guess they cast both creatures.
And now, they're going to Moody R and Beanie G, a Bony G. So what do we want? We want just an Arclight Phoenix, right?
Yeah.
So we thrill...
Let's thrill one of the Acolytes.
Wait, no, it's just a land.
Yeah, just a land.
Just a land, all right. Okay, so... I'll thrill the possibility.
I guess.
What?
You could fetch before.
Yeah, oh well. We're not about perfect plays here.
It's fine. We'll do it. Do you want a forest or a mountain?
We are about perfect plays here. I forgot about that. Probably
we
forest.
We take forest. All forest right. Can be anything.
Forest, and then thrill. No, that and that. Thrill, and then discard mountain. Okay, give me some good stuff. Give me some good stuff. Something just disconnected itself from my computer. I don't know what it is. Oh, it's reconnected, so it's all fine.
Okay. That's fine. So they have to... the giant is in hand. They want to kill the giant with it, right?
This?
Yeah.
With their giant, they want to kill our giant.
But that's
fine.
Oh,
no, but they can't do that. Then they die.
No.
Yes, whenever it becomes the target of a spell or ability.
Yeah.
Turn 4.
Yeah.
Yeah, but they block with the rider.
The not both copies
okay,
of it will resolve. Wait.
Yeah. I don't get it.
I don't know. Should I attack?
I think so.
All right, let's just attack with both.
Wait.
No, because then they just block innkeeper and take the giant.
And then they die because they're on four.
No, but rider has lifelink.
Oh, sure. Yeah, you're right. Okay. So,
they have a clover. Both of them happens.
So they block there. Yep, that's fine.
Yeah, I think not attacking. But because now they can kill. Actually, they could kill both now before we even draw a card. But I guess they kind of missed that.
Cast this, cast that, draw a card.
Okay. All right.
Man, an unanswered Edgewall Innkeeper is just...
A beating.
So good. Yeah, they should have killed the Innkeeper there, because they just gave us a card for free, basically. Sweet. Oh, this is Doom Cry, so sad. All right, so what's their plan? They have to play this Beanstalk Giant, right?
Yeah, but then if we get a Phoenix, we win.
Yes.
So let's do that.
All right, I'll draw.
Yeah, let's just win.
I'll draw an Arclight Phoenix. There are four of them in the deck. It's a lot of Phoenixes. Okay, there it is. That makes a lot of sense. So nope, that's not it.
Right. Once upon a time,
there was a Phoenix.
Once upon a time. There was an Arclight Phoenix, woo! And it won us the game.
Dang.
On the spot.
Fly, Phoenix, fly.
All right, next. All attack.
All right. Ding, ding.
Easy.
What are you willing to lose?
Never didn't have it. Okay, on the board. Whew, that was a real grind fest, huh? We had to really slug that one out.
Yeah, no early Phoenixes. Game didn't come for free.
No, it didn't come for free. Had to earn every inch of that victory. All right, back to it now. We got to get a turn one Arclight Phoenix. I guess the viewers... No, you know what? Maybe I won't make the turn one Arclight Phoenix the intro. Maybe
your next
so the viewers don't know if it's coming or not.
Yeah, that's very good. Okay.
This seems like a keep.
This seems like a turn two Arclight Phoenix.
Does it?
No.
No?
No.
No? Okay.
No.
I mean, it will be tough.
If we get a...
If we get a mana converter...
If we get a Rosethorn Acolyte, it is.
Yeah, maybe you're right.
Okay. Ye of little faith. All right, check this out. Here we go. So, go Mountain, Once Upon a Time. Rosethorn Acolyte.
Oh,
okay.
Oh,
yes. Maybe.
Who's the idiot now? Red.
It's still you.
Yeah, why isn't it the same?
Why?
Why can't you both be the idiot now?
I'm not the idiot. I predicted a turn to Arclight Phoenix, and both of you were like, no, never going to happen, not in 1,000 years, and I just did it. So, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I've been Riley Knight.
I've been Riley Knight. You've been Knight.
So, what do you want to do now?
Just play the Acolyte.
Play the Acolyte?
Yeah.
Very boring turn, but alright. And then get in there.
You know, get a mana dork going.
No, they will.
I can't believe... Like, I need to crow with Vindication here a little more, I think. That was so huge. Ooh. That was such a huge victory. And I'm not getting rewarded for it. And now we're going to get another Arclight Phoenix as well. Look at this.
But, wait. Don't we just do the beast thing?
That's not as cool.
That's true. I'm also in favor of Arclight Phoenix here.
Absolutely. Discard this.
But no.
We do the Arclight Phoenix thing, Toffle.
Okay. But then we get just Clarion and everything dies. We're all sad.
Okay. We'll just bring back the Phoenixes.
Yeah, we bring back the Phoenixes. Easy peasy. I don't
know
how.
With what army?
Easy peasy. Don't worry about it. How many spells have I cast?
One.
Oh.
You need to cast the Beast and the Thrill.
Okay.
Oh, wow, Toffle does not sound happy.
Yeah, he's so unhappy about it. He's such a cranky boy, mate. Come on, it'll be fun. It'll be fun. Don't worry about it. That's a shame.
Make a token?
Shock, yeah. So just make a token.
Oh, when We can shock the thing. Aww.
We can. Yeah. It's just...
Then it just doesn't block.
Okay. Yeah. Also, your line isn't much better against Deafening Clarion.
It is a fair bit
better. Keep all the spells.
Also, hard casting the Phoenix, I think, might have been just...
It was cooler to do it this way. It was cooler. Oh, listen, I'm trying to entertain the viewers here. And look, that's exactly what I'm saying. Exactly. Perfect. Perfect play. Get rewarded. Never didn't have it. Easy. And the viewers are sitting around, big smiles on their face, absolutely loving it. You boys.
Well, Topple is sitting around, big frown on his face.
Big frown on his face.
We do it my way.
Bottom lip poking out, arms folded across his chest like a petulant toddler. Unbelievable.
No kidding.
Unbelievable. Anyway. All right, very good. No. That was great. See? And you know what it was? Do you know what it was there? Because if we'd hard cast the Arclight Phoenix, that's not a power move. They look at that and they're just like, boring. Whereas the way we did it, they're like, wow, these guys are obviously great.
These guys rule.
I'm going to keep this hand.
Yeah, sure.
It's not great, but whatever.
Has a potential...
Uh-oh.
Turn three? Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, no.
I like how Gilded Goose is already doomed.
Yeah.
We're doomed.
No, don't. We don't find anything. What There's nothing we can find.
Yeah, I guess we can't find Shock, right?
So we can find an Innkeeper.
Yeah.
Oh, true.
Yeah. Let's have a look.
Oh, wow. You have such a huge brain, Toffle.
Absolutely. He's the
size of your brain is...
I mean, it leaks out his ears.
Incomprehensible.
So he has to put earplugs in to keep it in.
I feel like I'm getting reduced to the size of my brain a lot. I don't know how.
There's other parts of me. Don't you see me for what I am? Not just a big brain on legs? Right. Okay. No.
Okno.
Clearly, our opponent doesn't know what they're doing.
That's fine. I'd like to point out to everyone at this point as well, because we're going to get angry comments about how we pronounce it Oko and not Oko. And to those people, I say, I listen, I've heard your complaints, I've heard your concerns, and you can stick it up your bum, because I like saying Oko because it tilts people.
Who would actually have that thing? Like,
I would pronounce it Oko though.
Okay, let's Bone Crusher Giant the Goose.
I agree.
I like that plan.
The goose.
The goose
is on fire.
Did you guys play the Goose game on Switch?
Oh, absolutely. The Untitled Goose game?
Oh, I saw one of the streamers playing it.
It's very good. You'd like it a lot. You like mildly inconveniencing people, Toffle. And that's the entire conceit of the game, is just going around and just making people's lives just a little bit worse than they were beforehand. All right, respect.
Whoa, murderous riding the innkeeper.
Yeah,
I
think that's a very...
All right,
very
giant time.
Move. Giant time?
Yeah, giant time.
All right. Would you look at the time? It's giant time. All right. I like that this deck, so it, you know, it has that combo element. You can get a turn one, turn two Arclight Phoenix, whereas it also just has a play.
Yeah, it also has just a play pattern where you can just play mediocre cards.
No, like you play, okay, sure. It's like it does have Roast on Acolyte. That's fine. This is probably just an actively bad card. But, you know, playing the fail case of playing Bone Crusher Giant and playing Lovestruck Beast is not that bad.
Yeah, it's not terrible.
I mean, Lovestruck Beast especially is just a huge defensive brick wall, even without the 1/1. So, okay, not that huge, admittedly. Not as huge as a Rotting Regisaur. That's fine. I'll cop that.
Okay, so we just...
I guess we just block and kill it as a resort.
That seems fine.
So what do we do now?
Just say go. Do you want to cast Thrill of Possibility right now?
But then we can't kill it if we don't... Ah, we do, actually. Is the Acolyte an instant?
It's a sorcery. Oh my goodness, that's so much worse than I thought. All right, let's just say go.
Then we can also send our Lovestruck Beast on an adventure already.
Yeah? All right.
Yeah, let's do that.
All right, off you go.
I also don't hate the idea of taking 7.
I hate it.
Okay, all right, that settles it.
Okay.
I mean, it's 7 damage.
No attack? Or should I attack and, well, maybe they'll block?
No.
Oh, because we want them to have to discard a card as well. Okay, yep. Next level plays with our opponent. Fabled Passage on end step. We never saw it coming. Okay. What are they going to discard here? A Growth Chamber Guardian.
Ooh, growth. Wow, that's...
It's aggressive.
I mean, that's basically Ancestral Recall they're discarding there.
Yeah. It is. It's one mana, you draw three. Oh, wait, no. It's like...
wait, that's not it.
It's not quite it. It's 11 mana, you draw three. And they're all this, and they're all 2/2s that become 4/4s. It's not quite as good as Ancestral Recall. It's close.
I mean,
it's close.
It's an Ancestral Recall that draws you three more Ancestral Recalls.
Yeah, okay.
No,
you're right.
This has just gone off the rails.
No, Jamin, you know what? The number one rule of improvisational comedy is yes and. So I'm going to come with you on this journey. Yep, you're absolutely right, Jamin. It is an Ancestral Recall that draws more Ancestral Recalls.
Perfect.
We have to kill the Regisaur, don't we?
Especially
as this... Yeah, that's fine. We'll pop this up as a defender against the questing beast.
Unfortunately, it has Death Touch.
That's fine. It'll at least trade. All right, so we get
block.
Yeah,
then just get rid of the Regisaur. No, use the Giant.
What?
Womp womp. You could have used the Bone Crusher Giant.
Oh, excuse me. Sorry, that would have been much more mana efficient. You're right. 1,000 pardons. Let's just play.
Okay, so now we...
Let's play that.
Yeah.
That's all right.
Yeah.
They're kind of down on cards a little bit. I like our game as it goes a little bit longer. I don't know. Am I way off base with that or?
No, it's fine. We have the flyers.
If we can stall, it looks probably very bad. I wanted to say good, but then they play the Hydra.
No, but that's fine.
But the Hydra's fine.
That's fine.
Yeah,
as well.
We can still trade our questing beast, right?
Yep. Are they going to attack? Maybe they just don't attack. That's also very good.
They should attack.
I agree, but I don't think they... You know, they're considering it. All right, fine. So we snap block there.
Yeah, that's
fine. One of the good things about Thrill of Possibility... One of the things about... Not necessarily good things, but it's important to have bad cards to discard to it. So I'm glad we've included Rosethorn Acolyte so we can discard it to the Thrill.
Very, very smart.
So what do you want to do here?
So if we discard the Stomping Ground with Thrill, we can reanimate an Arclight Phoenix if we draw one.
But oh yeah, that's right. But we're going to discard this.
No, because then we can't reanimate Arclight Phoenix.
So you want to? All right. So you want to Thrill away the Stomping Ground?
Yeah. Why not?
I mean, we don't really need the lands, do we?
No.
I disagree 100%. But all right.
All right, there we go.
So now it's my turn to get dumped on. All right,
so Rosethorn Acolyte for something, and then Thrill away the Phoenix.
Rosethorn Acolyte for red.
Red,
and then
no.
Wait, no. Is this decline? Okay.
No,
that's not how that works. That's not how that works.
No,
decline is very different to cancel. Decline is very different to cancel, guys. Oops. Oh no.
I mean
wow. So you know how sometimes we have difficult turns and we're like, oh, the people in the comments, they'll sort it out. They'll tell us what we could have done better. Again, perfect play. There's not going to be any criticism whatsoever this week. Wow. All right. So, let's salvage this if we can.
Okay, play a land and the merchant or the acolyte. Don't cast anything. We need to kill the guardian before it evolves.
Oh, sure. All right. So cast the merchant. And then the Growth Chamber Guardian in response. Yeah. All right. Okay.
Oh, no.
I'm very sorry, boys. I'm very sorry to have stuffed that one up.
I mean, does a 3/2 flyer really matter?
I mean, it's not very good at the end of the day, really.
No, our opponent only would have been on 14, though.
No, that's the thing. It's not an appreciable fraction of their life.
And now 11.
Really. Well, all right, yes. You know what? We can sit here crunching numbers like bean counters all day, Toffle, or we can get on with the cool dude business of playing games of Magic. You know what they say? You got to play the hand that's dealt to you, Toffle. And if you stuff that up...
The hand that was dealt to us was with Arclight Phoenix.
Yes,
do you mean like
the
actual Magic hand or the hand as resources from your like capability of doing this?
I think in both senses it makes sense, but you know what it doesn't say?
Magic...
You know what the saying doesn't say? It says you got to play the hand you dealt, right? Everyone can agree on that. You know what it doesn't say? It doesn't say you have to play the hand that you're dealt well. It just says you have to play it.
Yeah, that's true. And we definitely played two instants.
All right.
So that's huge.
Do you want to play?
I guess we play Innkeeper and Giant and then try to value a little.
I like that.
Yeah. Yeah, it seems like our best bet.
Card. Okay, that's not bad.
We can keep that for a thrill. Oh no, we want to play it.
Do you not want to cast Thrill of Possibility? Or do you want... Oh no, I guess we want to string...
Yeah, no, I think actually just hard casting Arclight Phoenix is not...
I keep forgetting that you can do that. it's just a Volshock Berserker that, yeah, you can do like that. All right, so we take three, right?
Yeah, we have to double block.
All right.
And then no Murderous Rider, please.
Well, they can't, it doesn't matter. They can't... I guess they they can pay the extra two to do it, so...
They would have to use the... Oh, no.
Oh, no. This is bad. I want Assassin's Trophy.
Okay,
I probably would have targeted the other creature.
Yeah, maybe.
If I were my opponent there.
Wait, you just have to play the hand you're done.
Do you guys want to loot away the Phoenix with the Merchant?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm up for that. Oh, I have to do that now. Never mind. Never mind, guys. I've decided we're not going to do that after all. I thought about it and I agreed. And then I made the executive call. Okay. I made the decision.
But we're not doing it now.
We're not doing it.
No.
We're not doing
it. We're doing it in our turn for spell value.
Okay. All right. Oh, okay. Good. So
I guess we start by discarding.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thrill of Possibility, discarding Arclight Phoenix. Submit.
Yeah.
This has been an absolute train wreck. I do apologize, everyone.
Oh, I mean, that's what people sign up for. All right.
Okay, so now we once upon a time.
Yeah, now we once upon a time find another Phoenix and thrill that one.
And then discard it to the... all right, that's good. Okay, perfect.
Yes.
Yep, okay. Yep.
Okay.
And now, Thrill of Possibility, discard Arclight Phoenix, draw two. That was a much better turn. That was a lot better than I thought we could get it there. All right, and then...
All right, and pass.
We can play the mountain.
Yeah. I can play the mountain. Do you want to play the mountain?
Yeah.
All right.
Just don't attack.
No attacks?
Yeah, no.
And then mountain, and then your turn, opponent. Okay, yep. Eat up some food.
Okay, I mean, our opponent does not have an innkeeper right now, so they don't have the card advantage game going on.
That is true.
There's a shot. Also, if we draw another spell, we can get back Phoenixes.
Yes.
Yeah, and we have a decent shot on spells. Like, we draw multiple cards.
Yeah.
There's another Arclight Phoenix on the bottom of our library somewhere. Yeah. Yeah, because we bottomed one with what's it called there? Once Upon a Time.
Okay.
All right, so take three.
Yep.
Okay, block. See what they can do here.
Hope they don't have another removal spell.
Nope. Nice.
Okay.
Okay. All right. So Ferox down. We just need... We've got a lot of chances to find a spell because we can actually cast the Rosethorn Acolytes as well after using the ability to draw some cards.
Yeah.
So also, at least three draw steps. Like a
green into a green.
Yep.
All right. We know there might have been suboptimal. Perfect.
Good. All right. So green. Add green. Green. Add green.
Nice.
Make a 1/1. Play.
And then we play
a 5/5.
Yeah, play that.
See what
draw
we draw.
Some cards. Jeez.
And then play
okay.
a Rosethorn Acolyte. See what we draw.
I mean, yes, we're getting there.
Sweet. Okay. And now we can attack.
We should play the lands, and we attack with the phoenixes, right?
All right, sweet.
Yeah.
Get in there.
Jeez. Okay, okay.
Yay.
Turning this around. Turning this one around, boys.
Yes, okay. That doesn't matter too much.
We can beat that for sure. All right.
I mean, they only have two more draw steps or something. Yeah, once upon time, definitely.
Once upon time. See if we can find...
Another left stroke beast.
Take
That's
this.
Fine.
Yep. Play this and draw a card. Man, Edgewall Innkeeper, what a card. Oh, a little too late,
okay,
but whatever.
I guess we should have played Acolyte there, but whatever. Oh, yeah, we still can play Forest, play Acolyte.
Forest, play Acolyte.
Draw yet another card.
Oh, man, Edgewall Innkeeper is just so... I love this card, man. All right, so get in there with the Phoenixes.
All right, the next once turn again, they're dead because they... Yeah.
Once, I don't know how we pull this one out the bag, boys, but what a sensational victory. Yep, good game. And you know what?
Woo!
It was. That was actually good fun. I stuffed up a lot, but we still got there in the end. Whew.
Once you get your parity, the deck's pretty good. Because then you can start getting Phoenix value and...
Yeah, also Innkeeper is just ridiculous.
Yeah.
I said this like... When was it released? Like, yeah, a year ago or so, whenever Arclight Phoenix first came out. The thing that separates Arclight Phoenix as a recursive threat from cards like Bloodghast or whatever else is that it can block.
Yeah.
So you can set up situations where you're getting value off of your Phoenix on defense,
yeah,
which you just can't do with so many of the other recursive creatures. So, you know, and we saw that there. They were able to take down the Nullhide Ferox and then come back later on to attack. I'm going to mull
this. This is fine.
Yeah, no, I don't think so.
You sure?
Yeah, pretty sure. You have two draw steps or three draw steps, and then afterwards you don't even have adventure spells to go with your Lucky Clover.
Hmm. Interesting.
That's better.
Much better.
Right. Keep this and bottom a land.
Probably bottom a forest.
Yep. I think so too. Okay. What is our opponent up to here? Forest? Gilded Goose. No, Pelt Collector.
Ah, someone's mixing it up.
So just we kill Innkeeper. That. Just kill that?
No, kill it.
Kill it?
Why now? We can do that next turn with a giant.
Yeah, or we kill the next thing with a giant.
Yeah, I kind of like that, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Just keep him off the board.
Meh.
No, I like that, Chairman, because we can get the Innkeeper... Because we're not going to get any value off the Innkeeper for a couple of turns anyway. Oh, please, 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 2-2. Boo. All right.
Ooh, okay.
So now,
let's do that.
Lucky Clover.
Yeah.
Yep. Okay, so now we can Bone Crush the Goblin. Let's hope we draw a land next turn that isn't Fable
Hopefully
Passage.
Hopefully no Riot thingy with Hexproof.
You mean this one? You mean this exact card? Oops.
You mean this one?
We can still get rid of it, but we're taking a lot of damage by now. Okay, Innkeeper giant.
And Bone Crusher.
Yeah, we're crushing some bones here.
Crush this one or this one?
Yeah, the right one.
The riot one?
The riot one.
The correct one, please.
Alright.
Alright, ding dong.
Gotcha. Man. A Lovestruck Beast would be very good here.
Yeah.
A Lovestruck Beast would be very good.
Play the full amount?
We play four, yeah. Yep.
Yeah.
Alright, so different kind of beast. Alright, no blocks.
Goes to seven.
This is not looking good.
We have to cast a giant.
We need to play a giant.
Yep, and draw a land, preferably. Okay,
nope.
Possibility. Yuck. Alright, no attacks.
Alright, another questing beast. We need to chump block then.
Mm-hmm. It's trample as well, does it? No, it doesn't have trample. I always forget. I know it's got like 10... abilities,
yeah,
but trample's not one of them. But it can't be blocked by the Innkeeper anyway, so. Okay,
that's
fine.
Okay, that's fine.
Less fine.
So we go to one.
All right,
yeah,
so
we trade the giant, go to one. Oh, go to two.
Go to two? Or do you want to chump?
Why did I miscount? Yeah, just, no, don't chump now.
Go to two?
No, we go. Yeah. Ah, it doesn't trample. Yeah.
Okay.
So we need to block everybody.
Yeah. This is gonna be rough. I don't like our chances.
Yeah.
We can still find some Phoenixes, I guess.
We've got to be. Somehow. Yeah. All right. So we go.
So we merchant.
Go merchant.
Yeah, we're merchant the thrill.
Well, the Once Upon a Time is probably the worst.
Okay, sure.
Okay, merchant this. Okay.
Merchant thrill.
Thrill. Okay, another merchant. Mm-hmm.
Yep. Merchant.
The
forest?
Forest, yep.
Forest, yeah. We can still... Yeah, that's bad.
Okay.
Yeah, Innkeeper's not needed.
Okay.
Nope.
Wait, now we get two creatures?
So, yeah, yes. We get two Lovestruck Beast thingies.
So two of these. Okay, so not dead just yet. Pretty close to it, however. Do I play land?
Sure.
Yeah.
All right. And then no attacks. I'll probably just fetch so I don't have to keep clicking through it. I'll just get a green, I guess. Whatever. Okay, so attack with everything.
Yeah, chomp, chomp, chomp.
Chomp, chomp, chomp.
I mean, there's no coming back, is there?
No, it will be difficult.
Chomp, chomp, chomp. They've got a Collision Colossus. Fresh off the top. Like... Yeah.
All right. Sweet. Well, in that case, we're already dead.
They got us. Man, Gruul is such a powerful deck. I really, really like it.
You like the Gruul deck?
I really
beat
do.
Us up.
I know. It's a baddie, but I still really, really like it. Anyway, I don't know. I feel like we need one more win. I feel like we need to get. I feel like we need to once again.
We need one more Phoenix.
We need another. Oh, we need our Phoenix. Yeah, we need our Phoenix. We need our Phoenix clip. That's right. Everyone's been looking for that. So, with that in mind, one more.
One more.
So here we go. Here, the turn one Phoenix is obviously the dream.
Yeah. We were so close in that very first game of the day.
Yeah, we were very, very close indeed. But the thing is, like,
I mean,
Frank Carson said it was like 6% or something like that.
I mean,
oh,
come on.
No, we don't have a shot.
No, that's not a shot at turn one Phoenix, but that's a very potent hand.
All right, keep that.
And we need to once upon a time before everything else.
Hang on, is it not? If we go once upon a time into... No, we don't have enough pieces. All right. So once upon a time...
Probably take Phoenix. Yeah, take Phoenix.
Take the Phoenix. And then...
And then Innkeeper.
Innkeeper. All right, so we can... Arclight Phoenix. No, we need. Yeah, we're missing quite a few pieces, aren't we?
Yeah, we're just. Play Once Upon a Time here.
Okay.
And then.
Probably just a land, or do you want to do this so we can play the Phoenix? No, but even then, it's not enough.
Oh, I like. Yeah, land.
Just
it
a
has
land,
to be
right?
A land, doesn't
yeah.
it?
Okay, sure. Yeah. So we'll take like a.
Probably the mountain.
Mountain. Okay. And then, oh, serve. Get in there.
Ding. 19. What are they going to do?
First blood. We're definitely ahead. Okay, this is another person who has put a promo code as their username. I see these people quite a lot. I think they're people who signed up for Arena with a promo code somewhere, thinking that it was like a... I don't know, like a bonus that you get if they put a code in where their name should have been.
Yeah. Do we want to cast a giant? Just
giant.
Just a giant by itself. Just a naked giant. Draw a card. All right. Like that. And then, oh, Edgewell Innkeeper.
Ding.
Getting frisky again. Down to 18. What are they going to do?
If this is Esper Doom, I guess Phoenix is pretty sick.
And there's Teferi.
Bouncing the giant does not accomplish much.
No, it
that's
doesn't.
A card I haven't seen in a long time.
No, that's a card I've not seen in a long time. All right. Just.
Are we just playing Phoenix?
Just the Phoenix, I think, right?
Yeah. Take down Teferi with the Innkeeper. And...
This is the most damage.
The Phoenix.
This
I
is
like
the
it.
Most damage I think I've ever done with an Edgewall Innkeeper.
Yeah, I mean, how often has it attacked now? Three?
Three
four?
Times. Yeah, it's done three damage. All right, there's another one.
Bouncing that Phoenix also won't accomplish much.
No. Okay. I mean, they are drawing cards, I guess, but they're not...
Yeah.
They're not staying ahead. Yeah. So, just Phoenix again? Or do we just Bone Crush?
I think...
I actually like Clover Bone Crush.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's cool.
And then just play a 4-3, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that too, because we draw a card. get all the value off this innkeeper that we can, and then go kill Teferi again.
Yeah, this innkeeper has
MVP.
He's been throwing people out of the inn, like
just you know, serving.
Teferi coming in,
exactly,
doing nasty stuff. Nah,
he's
get
not.
Out of my
he's not serving up bloody pints of ale. He's serving up the left and the right here. Teferi's walking. He's like, no, mate. I told you, you're barred. You're banned. Get out. You're not allowed in this establishment.
I want another beer.
He's like, no, mate, get out. I'll tell you for the third time.
And then he tells his buddies, like, hey, this ink is so good. And then they bring more ink.
Wait. Oh, no. Ah, we're so close. If we could have...
Yeah.
It all?
So we have 12 damage in hand, right? We can deal 12 right now.
Oh, so we should have been...
If the phoenix already in the graveyard...
Yeah.
They would have been dead.
All right. As it is, what do you want to do?
Let's merchant. Let's find another phoenix.
We can also find the blue...
So...
The green ritual.
So haggle, right?
Yeah.
Haggle, discard phoenix.
Discard phoenix. Okay. Oh, that's...
That's enough, isn't it?
I think so, yes.
So discard the other merchant?
Yeah, discard merchant. Yeah, discard merchant.
We do 10. I know, we only do 10.
No,
it's not enough.
Oh,
we don't
enough?
Get the copy of the giant.
Oh, damn it.
But I think that's just good enough.
Okay, so what do we do here?
We just crush our opponent.
So, stomp?
Yeah, stomp opponent, stomp opponent.
I love this all offense, all aggro line that we're taking. It's great.
Like, they do have the egg, which is food.
And then...
But they have to deal with the creatures.
Do you want to crush them again, or do you want to play the 4-3?
I want to play.
No, we need to crush because of the spell, don't we?
What?
Ah, because there's a phoenix in the graveyard. Yes.
Yeah. Oh, right.
Tuffle's
okay.
Right.
So
we need to crush.
Crush again. And by crush, we mean stomp.
Yeah.
Right. And then shock?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, fancy life. Shock them.
Yeah.
Why do we shock? No, that's stupid.
Yeah, nobody knows.
Nobody knows.
We're getting in there. But get rid of Teferi, please.
Yeah, we can. Yeah.
All right. So they're dead next turn.
Maybe we should have attacked them. Because now if they crack the food, they go to 4.
Okay, Doom Foretold. So we can just sacrifice the clover.
Yeah, but now they're just dead, right?
Yeah, no, don't. Yeah, like with the trigger on the stack.
Yeah, you shock them. Yeah.
Nice. Yes, this is great. This is magic.
Yeah, so they can crack the egg in response, but then there's another one coming, so it doesn't... Yeah. Got him.
Ding! Woo!
Easy. Man, love it.
I mean, we didn't get a lot of wins with the Phoenix, but the deck performed.
The deck really performed very well indeed, actually. I'm very impressed by it. I mean, you look, it is... I think it's like a 6% chance, right, to get the... to get the Arclight turn one. We got a turn two, which is definitely like a modern playable start. But what I really like about this deck is that it can play a much longer game. Like, it plays a much longer game with its adventure cards and Edgewall Innkeeper and Lucky Clover than you would think for a deck that's also trying to reanimate Arclight Phoenix.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, I think
those adventure cards are just actually good.
They're actually very good. Roastthorn Acolyte is the obviously glaring exception, but apart from that, like, I'm not embarrassed to play any of the other cards in this list.
Honestly, the Acolyte coupled with Innkeeper is still a good card.
Yeah, true. I mean, if it's a 2/3 that draws a card and gives you... And the other thing is, late in the game, you actually use the extra mana because, you know, all of your other cards are cycling.
You often loot away lands,
yeah.
Right?
Well, and just the fact that we had that turn, you know, where we turned the corner, where we played, like, Bonecrusher Giant into Merchant, into Lovestruck Beast. Like, we had 9 mana worth of plays that were still drawing cards and having access to extra mana. So, yeah, I don't think it's... I really like this deck. I think it's actually very, very good.
Yeah, I agree.
Excellent.
Like, very, very good. I don't agree.
Okay. It's very good. In terms of Arena Boys, it's very, very good. In terms of the power level of the decks we play, it's actually one of the better ones. But it's also a ton of fun, and it's going to catch people off guard while they're trying to, you know, crush with their Occos. You just get them with an Arclight Phoenix. Easy game. Don't worry about it.
That's certainly true.
All right, we're done for another week. Thanks for hanging out with us. It's been a lot of fun. And thank you once again to Harrison JR, who sent in this list. I will mention that Harrison sent it in quite a number of weeks ago, and we've only just got to it now. So if you've got a list you want to share with us, please do, and we'll put it on the pile. And again, we come back to them all the time. So
we play old lists very often.
Very often indeed. So if you don't see it within the first little bit, don't worry about it. It's on the pile. It's on the list, and we may get to it before too much longer. If you want to send us in lists, the best way to do that is on Twitter, of course. You can see there, at the Arena Boys is a good way to get in touch with us. Or you can DM them to me personally, at Riley Crew Tower. Make sure you follow us all on Twitter, at Riley Crew Tower for me.
At ToffleMDG for me.
And at Jack O'Mattress.
And the other thing, of course, make sure you check out Channel Fireball and all the other stuff, especially the stuff that I make. Got to get those clicks up, got to get those numbers up, got to make it look like my content is worthwhile, people are engaged in it. You don't even have to listen to watch it. Just go and click on it, make sure you seem like you're engaged. Just mute it.
Take a five,
That's it. That's all I want. Scry Me River with Dennis. What else have I got going on? Got the countdown, whatever else, and of course, more Arena Boys next week. Thanks for hanging out with us. We'll see you next week for more nonsense. Until then, it's time to exit the arena.
Boys!